didn't kill her. She survived and thrived. Her era nicknamed her Chappan Churi, she of the 56 blades. Janki Bai, one of the foremost singers of the gramophone age, the daughter of a poor sweet maker of Banaras, was trapped in an Allahabad brothel at an early age. She wore her disfigurement with pride and rose to be a musical celebrity, performing at princely darbars and aristocratic celebrations, but always returning to her beloved Allahabad. At the Delhi Darbar of 1911, she performed before the King Emperor George V and Queen Mary of Teck. International record companies like Pathephone, Columbia, Odeon, and GTL pursued her. She recorded about 150 discs with them and commanded a massive audience. Her story, like her crumbling grave, is a mislaid memory worth revisiting. That's her tomb, called Chappan Churi Ka Mazar. Behind the public self was a private life of vexation and pain, disappointment and loss. A life of lonely but persistent overcoming. Of powerful choices which went against the grain of social conformity, broke all the stereotypes of stardom, a life in which emotional losses were compensated by spiritual gains in art. It's the summer solstice, the hottest day of the year, when I stepped into her Sabzi Mandi lane, where she lived much of her life. A little distance away, the clock tower of Allahabad's chowk rears its head above clumps of branches and tangled electric wires. That's what remains of her main house, shoddily built over. Above an electronic goods shop, an overhanging balcony, unpainted walls, hollow doorways, a niche for an oil lamp. A faith healer lives in it now. There are alley legends about her. Meet Janki Bai Ilahabadi. Her friends, the well-known poet Akbar Ilahabadi, the sparkling diva Gohar Jan, musicians Makhdoom Bakhsh, Rahimuddin Mia, Ghasite and Ramlal Bhatt, her lively fellow courtesans at the Kota, her tragic family. Explore the precious Gharana lore about music and musicians preserved by votaries of Hindustani music. Replay the Raga of this impressive life, Janki Bai Ilahabadi, artist and woman extraordinaire,